Using a specification-driven 3D package means we're limited to the components defined within the given spec. However, situations may arise where adding a component not included in the spec becomes necessary. To handle these cases, the custom parts builder provides a solution. Let's walk through the process of integrating an off-spec component into a model. Start by opening the drawing file labeled 06-05-piping. Select a specific area to work on. Let's choose a section to add some valves. We'll place several different valves along the selected line to observe the outcomes. If a valve isn't available in the spec, there are two options for adding it, through the parts insertion section or the custom parts option in the tool palette. Exploring the custom parts builder, we'll see options to manipulate various body shapes, actuators, and dimensional data. This parametric approach allows for the creation of components tailored to specific requirements, such as a valve that matches unique dimensions. For instance, we can input specific face-to-face dimensions or adjust the actuator's height and width. Navigating the shape browser, we'll select a plant 3D shape and choose a valve configuration. Let's insert a flanged valve body and customize it as needed. Adjustments can be made to the dimensions and connections directly in the properties panel. Let's add a globe valve to the line. First, I'll select a flanged globe valve, drag it over, and place it in the model. As you can see, the flanges and handwheel are added automatically. Next, I'll switch to a socket welded globe valve. Watch closely as I drag and place it into the model to observe what happens. When placing a non-spec valve, placeholders serve as interim components. For example, inserting a socket welded globe valve without the corresponding spec will generate a placeholder marked with an exclamation point. This placeholder provides basic details, such as its nominal diameter, but it indicates that the part is unavailable in the spec. Placeholders are useful because they allow design work to continue without interruption. They can be replaced later with the correct components once the spec is updated. This approach ensures smooth workflow continuity while accommodating later corrections. In conclusion, utilizing placeholders and the custom parts builder allows for flexibility in maintaining progress on a design, even when required components are initially unavailable in the spec.